Well, Zika was first described actually in Uganda way back in the 1940s, and it was actually probably hiding out in monkeys there. It was first discovered in the zoo and some monkeys, and then it spread to a few human cases. Pretty quiet over the years, and then popped up again all of a sudden in 2007 in the South Pacific in Micronesia, actually. And then there was another outbreak a couple of years ago in Tahiti, and somehow it's gotten from Asia now to the Americas. There was a big outbreak in Tahiti, and the speculation is that it came with the World Cup, that somehow, because of all the fans that came to Brazil during the World Cup in 2014, that the disease jumped there. So it's in humans. It's transmitted by a mosquito called Aedes aegypti, and maybe other species of Aedes mosquito. And so it doesn't seem to be established in a reservoir of monkeys in Latin America. Right now, it's a human-to-human epidemic. For the person that's actually infected, that's not pregnant, it is just like a bad flu with a rash. It is fever, headache, some conjunctivitis, maybe some mild joint pains. And it really just lasts along with a mild rash, and it really just lasts for a few days. So just like a flu. No drugs to prevent, no drugs to treat, and no vaccine. This disease was not on our radar, and no vaccine was even in development up until about last week. Yes, there have been reports from Brazil of around 4,000 babies that were born with microcephaly, small heads, and a number of stillbirths and spontaneous abortions, miscarriages. This seems to be occurring in the very same areas that have had high rates and big outbreaks of Zika, especially in northeastern part of Brazil. And I think we have to caution that it's going to take a long time, probably a number of months, to really definitively say that there's an association. You have to do very detailed association and epidemiologic studies, because remember, just because a baby is born with a congenital malformation and has evidence of infection doesn't mean that the infection caused the malformation. I think it's important to emphasize, though, that the density of mosquitoes in the United States is just not what it is in these other countries. So we, and I would say the density of the population neither. I mean, in order to sustain an epidemic, you need a lot of people that are very close together and a lot of mosquitoes that are very close together, and that allows the virus to transmit much more efficiently. We don't have the population densities in the southeastern United States, and we don't have the mosquito densities. And so there's really much less concern that there's going to be a widespread outbreak here in the United States. There may be some little local outbreaks in neighborhoods or communities that will sort of snuff themselves out with time. For the person that isn't a woman of childbearing age, you know, I don't have much concern at all. It's a mild disease. It's like getting the flu. It's a lot less serious than many of the diseases you're exposed to when you travel to developing countries. So the advice, mosquito repellent, and you'll minimize your risk of getting it. It's more difficult for women of childbearing age. You know, the advice would be, out of an abundance of caution till we know if this association is true, that pregnant women should consider not traveling until we know more about this disease, and that women who absolutely want to be cautious should probably wait for a period of time, a couple of weeks, 3 weeks after their trip, in order to become pregnant if they're not already pregnant.